Wagwan beautiful people, welcome to yet another video. I hope you guys are feeling good. I am glad to be back with another video, and in today's video we are back with the Premier League and we are at home. We are facing Everton, and Everton have not been having the best season, so we might have a chance of winning this game. Now guys, I have to talk about this. You know, the Man City game versus Leeds, the Man City versus Leeds game happened yesterday. And the way Man City beat Leeds, 7-0, and we were able to just come out of that game with a close shave of a 3-2 win. I'm embarrassed. I am absolutely embarrassed. And Man City, of course, they don't have injuries. They are at their best form. You have to put those factors into consideration. But still, no excuses. And with that in mind, I feel like we should be able to nick in as many goals as possible in this game. We still have a bit of injuries, some good news. I'll be giving you some Chelsea news, some general news related to the AFCON, related to the AFCON happening in January. And of course, I will be telling you my starting 11. And then of course, I'll be giving you my score prediction. So if you enjoy this content, please make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Share it with your family and friends, and please don't forget to subscribe. Turn on the post notification bell so you're notified every time I upload a video. Now let's jump right into it. Now let's start with the news. Now I thought I would mention this. CAF are having discussions about the AFCON, that there's a possibility that it might be postponed or might be stopped. Now I feel like the major factor here is COVID, and it's just sad. I mean, I know Euros were not stopped because of COVID, and then now we have to stop the AFCON because of COVID, but then at the end of the day, health is more important. So if this is the case, the talks are still ongoing, and I'll be giving you an update on what happens. So that is the latest in terms of the AFCON. There's a possibility it might be postponed or it might be stopped for a while till further notice. Now, of course, in terms of the Premier League also, I have to mention, due to the COVID situation, some matches, of course, the Premier League board were asked to postpone some matches due to the high number of cases of COVID happening. And this happened to the Man United versus Brentford game. It had to be postponed, and they have clearly put out a statement that no more matches will be postponed. Now, moving forward, I feel like the best option would be to put in less fans. That's my opinion, but less fans probably. And if fans are not able to be limited going in, I don't know what should be done. But as it is right now, the board of the Premier League will not be postponing any more games. So that is in terms of COVID. So, and of course, there was a bit of news in terms of the players, and I'll be telling you who will be available and who will not be available. So Thomas Tuchel was asked whether having the COVID jab will determine on whether or not he will be signing players in January. He mentioned that we have a very strong squad and he's not looking for signing of any players. So that's a good thing. So in terms of our squad, it's good to see that our coach has faith in the team, and I am glad to see that, you know, he has so much faith that he's not even considering other players. But of course, I don't think he'll just disclose it and go and be like, oh yeah, I've been thinking about signing this player and this player. You know how Chelsea like to do their deals behind closed doors. So it is what it is. As we're talking about the transfer news, I thought I should just mention, you know, I did not know this, but apparently it's 17 more days till the transfer window is open. And some of our players, including Aspi, Christensen, and Rudiger, are going to be free agents in 17 days. Now, Thomas Tuchel did not seem worried. He was a bit shocked with the news that it's 17 days till the transfer window is open. But those three players are likely to be free agents. And of course, no discussions. He does not disclose transfer talks within the press conference, as I said, behind closed doors. So he mentioned that In terms of the players, of course, they know what they want in terms of their career, and they will be discussing with them in the weeks to come. So no contract has been set. Of course, there were rumors about Christensen signing in on a contract. Thiago Silva too apparently was set to sign a contract till 2023, but it's yet to be confirmed. That was according to Fabrizio. So let's see what happens. Then, while we're still talking about the transfer news, now, apparently, according to Absolute Chelsea, Antonio Rudiger's agent, who is also his brother, has been said to be in talks with PSG, and as it is right now, they are still going on. They're still going on with talks, and so many rumors, you know, circulate around the league that he's one of the best defenders in the world right now. And of course, Sky Sports mentioned that Man United have joined in the interest of signing Rudiger. Now, would I think Rudiger will go to Man United? I highly doubt. I think he's just stalling and he's one of the best. He knows what he's doing. He's looking for a higher salary. And give him the damn contract! Give him the contract. Give him the salary he wants. He's doing phenomenally. What he did for us in the league game, as close as it was for us to lose, guys, what more does he need to do for you to give him the contract? Just give him the damn contract, okay? So that is in terms of Rudiger and transfer talks and the AFCON news. So let's jump into the injury updates. Now, in terms of the injury updates, some good news. N'Golo Kante and Trevoh Chalobah were in training for the past two days, and this is great. I mean, of course, I don't expect him to be back, and I don't expect him to be back playing in the game against Everton, possibly on the game on Saturday. But I expect, this is good news. I mean, the midfield was really affected, and we saw how bad it was. But in terms of Kovacic has two more days till he's out of quarantine, I think. And then in terms of Ben Chilwell, he is set to recover, and most likely will not be. Most likely the doctors are yet to determine whether or not he will be requiring to do a surgery. Now, I hope he does not get to that, and I hope he's able to come back in January. So that is in terms of the injury update. Now, with that in mind, of course, Thomas Tuchel was asked about Lukaku, and the way he's not been informed, of course, he's not been starting most of the games. He comes in mostly as substitutions, and he gave us a sneak peek that possibly he might be starting tomorrow, possibly for 70 minutes, and then another player might come in his place. Now, in terms of the front three, of course, we have a load of players who are always being circulated. Some players don't get to play as much, but I feel like some players, now will be a very good time to rotate them. And with that in mind, this will be my starting 11. So I'll be having the 3-4-2-1 formation. Now, Everton, as I said, they've not been in their best form. Their last game against Crystal Palace, they conceded 3 goals and they only were able to get in 1 goal. So we might have a chance. So I'm not underestimating them either way. So I am expecting a tough game, but at the same time, please let us win this game. Man City and Liverpool ain't joking. I will keep repeating this and I will keep saying this. They are not joking. So we need to be in our best. We need to be bring our best forward. We need to do our best. And if we are still eyeing the title, I know Man City will not. It will just if they lose guard their way in this run, in this race, it will be by mistake. And they're in their best form. They're not conceding as many goals. They are scoring in as many goals as possible. 7-0. 7-0. Well, it was a nice game. I watched it. I enjoyed it. But, yo, hey, we need to do better. And we have to consider the fact that we have injuries. And these are not excuses. These are facts. So, with that in mind, this will be my starting 11. With a 3-4-2-1 formation, I'll be having Mendy in goal. And then I will be having Rudiger, Thiago Silva, and then at the other end I'll be having Christensen. Then in terms of the midfield 4, I will be having Alonso, as we have no other left wing back. I still feel like we need to sign another left wing back, by the way. So that's just by the way, but Alonso will be my left wing back. And then at the pivot, we don't have so many options, so Jorginho and Ruben Loftus-Cheek. But Thomas Tuchel mentioned that N'Golo Kante will be on the bench tomorrow, so might he come as a substitution? I don't think so. Possibly towards the end, maybe if the game is going south for us, so possibly, but I don't think so. So Roman Loftus-Cheek and Jorginho at the pivot, and then at the end, Rhys James. Now, Rhys James' game against Leeds was not his best, but hopefully he can come back. He has given us goals. It would be nice to see more goals from this game, you know? No pressure, but it would be nice. Then, in terms of the front three, now this is where I have a bit of an issue. I feel like Lukaku will start, because Thomas Tuchel mentioned he might be getting 70 minutes of the game tomorrow. So, basic affiliation, he might definitely start. So now, the likes of Ziyech, the likes of Christian Pulisic, Callum Hudson-Odoi, Mason Mount's game was phenomenal. Mason Mount, and right next to him, I will be having Ziyech. Maybe Ziyech will be making a comeback. I mean, his game in the Champions League, the game again, in the Zenit game, he was great. And it would be nice to see him get more game time. There have been rumors circulating that he wants to leave the club possibly in January. Just the fact that he's not starting a lot. But hey, rumors. But where they smoke, there's fire. So I predict Mount to start, Hakim Ziyech to start. And then up front, I predict Lukaku to start, possibly 70 minutes. And then when the 70 minutes are covered, possibly we might see Christian Pulisic, Callum Hudson-Odoi making substitutions. So that is in terms of my starting 11. Now, in terms of my score prediction, I predict Everton have not been in their best form, but I don't want to jinx it. So I am predicting a win for Chelsea. I am predicting, this is making goals. I know we're not a Man City, I know at the moment we're not in our best form, we're having so many injuries, but we can still do it. We have done it in the past. Let us sneak in as many goals as possible. So I'm predicting a 3-1, 3-0. Let's keep a clean sheet. It's not easy. Mendy, of course, after the West Ham game, his confidence has not been at its best. So I think he's yet to get there. And Thomas Tuchel mentioned, we have been spoiled. We have been spoiled with clean sheets. We have been spoiled with leading the table. We have been spoiled with the Champions League. Speaking of the Champions League, I thought I would mention this as I'm finishing the video. Of course, there was a bit of that saga where the UCL draw, the round of 16, we were able to draw Lille. We were able to draw Lille. And then, of course, the draw had to be done again. And some other clubs got different opponents. But I mean, the likes of Atletico, even in their poster, did not put Ronaldo. They put Bruno Fernandes. But hey, just for fun, it is what it is. And as the second draw happened, of course, there was a mistake apparently with how the draw was made, and UEFA had to apologize and do the draw. There was a redraw. We still got Lille. So you know, on Twitter, of course, everybody was happy. Online, on social media, they were like, the gods are for us, we're so lucky. But hey, we should not underestimate them. They were the first in their squad, in their group. They were the first in their group, so we should be able to have an easy one. Of course, Champions League is not happening till next year, but it's good that we settled with Lille. So I'll be taking Lille over Bayern or any other. But anyway, guys, that is in terms of my preview today. If you enjoyed the content, please make sure you give it a thumbs up. Share it with your family and friends, and please don't forget to subscribe. Turn on the post notification bell so you're notified every time I upload a video. I will be seeing you in my next video.